Hello everybody and welcome to my channel. It's Eva from Bohemian Crafting and Happy New Year to you all, and thank you so much for everybody who are coming today and who are sharing the time with me. I would like to thank you so much for all support you gave me through the last year and those years before. Without you, I wouldn't be here. And I hope that you will all have a wonderful 2022, and it will be much better year than that previous one. And thank you especially for everyone who are supporting my Etsy shop and for my amazing Patreons, because they went through a lot last year with me. They know a lot of what was happening in my life, and their support helped me to go through to a very hard time in my life. So thank you guys very much. You can't even imagine how much love I received from all of you, from this craft family, and how much you helped me with dark side of the life. So I really hope that this year I will show you how much I appreciate everything, all your support and everything you are giving me. And I'm coming today with first video, with my first video in 2022, with small pattern for you if you would like to get it. It will be for free, and it is pattern for planner. It's a very simple planner, and very simple planner. I should have it somewhere here. I just lost it in the pile of other stuff. No, I do have it. So it is this pattern for a weekly planner page. It's really simple. It's nothing complicated, and I do have tutorial which will be coming right now after my talking here. If you would like to get this pattern, just click on the link down below. It is for free. If you would like to take get it, I do have that pattern on a white background, very clear and very clear. And then there is also pattern with kind of like vintage style, with that vintage paper feeling. That's what I used here, and I just created this small book. I'm continuing with editing frames like this. This is not in that tutorial, but all that rest is in the tutorial. Also, how you can stitch the book, which can be extendable, which you can use through the all year, and you can add there the pages through to all year, and I hope without any huge issues. I really hope this tutorial will be also for beginners, if they want to try their first very easy way to make a journal. So, link will be down below for this pattern. That will be for free. There will be also a link for... I created my designs for covers, and they are exactly for this book. So, if you want to get these, there will be a link as well. And I'm continuing to kind of like, you know, to decorate these things. But the tutorial, how I made this book, is coming right now. And I really hope you will enjoy that. So here is the design I have created for that book. You will have a chance to download it clear without any vintage shades. Or with that vintage feeling, where is there also kind of like a tea-dyed paper. So it looks like this. I printed out with that tea-dyed paper background, and I printed out on ivory cardstock 160 GSM. You don't have to use that heavy paper. I just like to use it with this grammage. And all around is kind of like frame, so you will need to fussy cut out all around. So... my printer is printing with this frame around. And if you do have printer which is printing from the side to the side, you don't have to cut these long sides. And bottom, if your printer is printing on full page, you don't have to cut the bottom and those two long sides. You will need just cut the shape of these pages here on the top. I have to cut all these four sides, so I'm gonna fussy cut out. Now, to make it a little bit easier, I'm gonna fold it on half because I did cut it hopefully nicely. So I'm gonna fold it half and then I'm gonna go both sides at once. I'm cutting with a small edge of my vintage paper around that shape, and it should be good for both sides if I fold it right. Yeah, good, I do have both sides. Now, fold it, where is this line here? So fold it there. And you do have the base for your journal, for your 2022 planner. So this is the base. You will have pocket here, pocket here, and you do have Monday till Sunday plus a note here on the bottom. Now, if you want, you can use just glue and put a glue here in that fold and place it here and let it dry. That way you will have pockets like this, which are open on the sides. Or you can use a sewing machine, or you can put a glue on these three sides and place it on the paper and let it dry, and you will have pocket from the top. Or as I will do, I'm gonna use the sewing machine and sew this side and then this side. That way I'm not gonna put glue here in the middle because it will be folded and sewn to the spine of my book, so it will be secured, and I will have pocket here and here. Before I will do that, I like to make my page a little bit more vintage. I'm gonna use the distress inks from Ranger, and I'm gonna use a ground espresso for a darker color, and this one, it's tea dyed. This is the color which is making that distress ink. And as a tool, I'm gonna use the brush, and I will probably do some stamping and create my pocket pages. And that how it looks like. My pocket pages, I did use some stamping and I did use my distress inks all around of these edges to make it a little bit more vintage. Here you can see that sewing, this side and this side is exactly the same, and when you will place them together, it makes so cute edges of that book. So I do have prepared 14 of these pages, and it's one quarter of the year. It's still end of March. I counted just right now how many weeks we have till end of March, and it's 14. So I do have 14 pages, and I'm gonna start to create a cover for my book plus spine. For creating my book cover, I'm gonna use this old envelope which came with some goodies from Amazon. It's nice heavy cardstock, so I'm gonna use that. You can use some cereali box, some box from another food which is clean, not with some leftovers from that food. You can use some cardboard boxes, chipboard, anything you have. The perfect is what you've got right now at home. So go to have a look, or maybe some old book cover you can use. The size of my pages is 4x8. So that's what I'm gonna cut, 2 pieces 4x8. And then I'm gonna cut 2 pieces 4 1/8 by 8 1/8, a little bit bigger than those first 2 pieces. So I do have my 2 4x8 inch and 2 pieces 4 1/4 by 8 1/4 inch. And they will go like this, one on another one. and it will make a beautiful frame. I'm gonna take those top pieces and I'm gonna choose some kind of paper I would like to have on the top. And these bottom papers I'm gonna wrap to probably to black wrapping paper. I'm not gonna use anything complicated. So I decided to create some kind of front cover and back cover for my book. It is in the size of those pieces 4x8, like this. And I do have front cover and back cover. I will put link for these two covers down below as well. You can use any kind of paper you have. You can use newspapers if you want. If you will want to use these, I'm going to show you how to make it work. So I'm going to take a ruler around those images. It's a frame which will help you to fold that paper the way when then you can just easily add that cardstock on the back side and wrap that paper around your cardstock. So use some kind of tool which will help you to score the line. It can be proper scoring tool, or you can use scissors, and with the closed scissors just put the ruler on that line and use your scissors as a scoring tool. Or you can use kitchen knife, but not with that sharp edge, but with that opposite edge. Someone told me lately that a knitting needle can be perfect for scoring. That's actually a wonderful idea. I just don't have any knitting needle. So I'm gonna use my scoring tool and I'm gonna score these lines from the top to the bottom of my paper. I'm gonna fold these score lines. And now I can take a glue, put a glue on my piece of cardstock, and place the piece in that folded part. So I'm gonna slide it to this side and slide it to the top, and those other two sides should just follow. Glue it down. So I should be on the right spot. If I will fold it, yes, I'm on the right spot. So now I'm gonna take scissors, I'm gonna cut the papers around. Sorry for that noise of my scissors. And I'm gonna glue these sides. Right. Here I'm just following that chipboard or that card on there. And because we scored those lines, that folding around the chipboard should be very easy. So I do have prepared my front and the back cover, and I use those distress inks to make it look more vintage. And same way, like I wrapped to the paper these front covers, I wrapped first those larger pieces to back paper. And then I wanted to make this, that sewing effect all around, but because it's so hard to see the edge of the black paper when you are sewing, so I had to place it on coffee dyed paper, and then I just cut it with a small lift all around of that coffee paper to make sure that I will see the edge of that black paper. And I actually like it. It looks more vintage. So my layer of the covers will be this way, but before I will put it together, I'm gonna create a spine where I will sew the pages. So the spine will be very easy. You can make spine as big as you want. I've got here a leftover if you wanna sew then later more pages, and I will show you how to do it. Even if you will have book full of pages and you wanna add there maybe envelope or something, so you can with this sewing. So I'm gonna show you what I'm gonna do. Easy spine. The spine which will make your book expandable, or pages inside expandable. I've got here my one of my pages. I've got here a piece of that envelope, and I'm gonna place that page on the bottom in that corner, and here in this corner I'm gonna make a mark on my cardstock on that envelope. So it's right here, and I'm gonna cut that cardstock right here. So I do have, this piece is 4¾ by 7, and I have no idea what is this one. It's right behind 1/4. So 7 and something. I'm sorry, in centimeters, it's much more easy to say in centimeters. It is 18½ by 12. It's much more easy to say. So this will be how tall my spine will be. And now I'm gonna create how wide the spine will be. And I'm gonna take my ruler. I'm gonna take my ruler like a help. I'm gonna slide it to one edge of that card to make it straight. And I'm just gonna score. That will be one side folded. And here I'm gonna do same. I'm gonna put my ruler to the edge, and I will make very big spine. So I can, I guess I can place there all 50 pages if I will do it this way. It will be a really big spine for my book, like this. So then it will be here and here. If you wanna have spine exactly for your pages, grab them together, measure it, and 1¼. So I'm gonna score one side the way I did, and then from that score line I'm gonna measure 1¼, and I'm gonna make a mark. But I think I'm gonna make a spine 1½, so I'm gonna make a mark 1½, a little bit bigger, because I would like to show you how you can add there also some envelopes. When you've got there your pages, maybe in the time you will want to add there something more. So this will be spine of my book. So this will be my spine. This shorter piece I'm gonna glue between those layers, between I think on back cover. This will be back cover. So between those two layers, I'm gonna glue this small piece like this. And this larger piece I will use as an envelope here. Oops, envelope here, I'm guessing. So first I'm gonna put a glue on this shorter part. I'm gonna take that larger piece of paper, and now the right way to place it, right way, it will be like this. So I'm gonna place it here, make a nice position to find out the way I would like to see those papers in. It will be sewn around, so I'm kind of measuring if I can fit in there with those pages. And I'm gonna glue it together like this. This will be the back cover of my book, so I think I can glue it straight away together. So I'm gonna put a glue here. And if you would like to create there some kind of closure, you can add in the middle of this piece, maybe ribbon. This way, place glue here and put a ribbon which is coming out this way, because this will be back cover, and glue it down. So once the one side is dry and glued properly together, hopefully it will hold nicely. I'm gonna glue this, which will make my pocket at the front cover to that front cover. I'm gonna fold it down. I'm gonna put glue on these three sides here, here, and here. I'm gonna take this and place this front cover here on that spine, and here I'm gonna make sure that these sides and these sides are matching. So not like this, but to make sure that they are matching together, that they are sitting nicely. And I'm gonna let it dry. So I added that stitching all around of that pocket as well. So from here, I do have nice pocket. I'm gonna flip it over and I can glue my front cover. So I'm gonna put a glue all around of this piece and glue it on the top. And again, if you are making closure, if you already added the ribbon here, you should make that here as well. So in the middle, if you want to place it on the exact spot, like you've got that ribbon here, just place this here, the way where it's the right way. This should be on the top, this should be on the bottom. So place it this way. And where there it's coming out, the ribbon from your back cover, put a glue here and put on the same spot ribbon this way. And then just take it, flip it over and glue it to your book here. And your closure will be on the exact same spot. The ribbon from here will be on exact same spot. I'm gonna let this dry to make sure it's nice and steady. And now how to add the pages into this journal, and it's so easy. You can do it weekly, you don't have to sew a book at the first. You can do your pages separately from the book cover to make there some decoration, to make some sewings, put stickers, anything you want. And then take your book cover, take the thread, put the thread around and make a knot. You can decorate that thread with beads, or you can take every week different color of thread. You can add there, beads. So you can make your choice of the threads you're gonna use. You can make pattern from the threads as well on your spine. You just need to wrap it this way and then you sew your book page. Move it to the side. Cut the thread in the leg you wanna see. You can add here some kind of decoration, some charms, anything you want. And you've got your first page sewn inside. Then next week is coming, make your decoration, fill it up, put there some stickers, anything you want. Then take another thread, place it here and sew it around. This way you can add to your journal's pages weekly. So I have sewn all my signatures or my pages inside, and I already also sewn, after I had sewn all these, I added there an envelope. So maybe you already have your book done and you wanna add somewhere some envelope or some leaflet. So you can just make a space for it. Create from paper, easy envelope. I'm gonna take a ruler and again some embossing tool, and I'm gonna score about 1/4 inch from one side. About 1/4 inch from other side. I'm gonna fold these. I've got here one of these pages left, so I'm gonna place that page here and I'm gonna place it to the edge, match it to the edge and fold this over. Just kind of taking measurement how big envelope I can do. And then I can fold it somewhere here. And it's just by eye. I think somewhere here. So this will be flap of my envelope. This will be the envelope itself. So I'm gonna take scissors and cut this corner where I do have that folded line, and this corner to that folded line. So here, these folds I'm gonna use for gluing this part and make a pocket. And these folds, I'm not gonna cut it off, I'm gonna flip it over and fold them up. And I'm gonna use them to reinforce the edges. So I'm gonna add their glue. And fold it. Add the glue here and fold it. If you like to use the sewing machine, so before you will sew it to your paper, to your booklet, you can use the sewing machine before you will glue this pocket down, or before you will actually sew it first to your book and then glue this pocket down. You can make some decorative sewing all around of your envelope, like this. And then take your book, take a twine, open the book at the spot you wanna add there your envelope, fold these sides inside, put your envelope on that spot where you wanna add it, take the twine, make sure you have everything separated, including these strings here on the bottom. Put the string around your envelope. Where is it? Make a knot. And then add the glue on these two folds and glue it. Glue it here and you just created an envelope in the middle of your book. And this is when you add few more those envelopes, and when you use two different twines or strings, you can use many different colors. You can make it like a rainbow and make your journal this way very colorful. So I hope you did enjoy this tutorial. It is very easy way how to make extendable journal. You can make the spine really huge and then add there all year, so it's totally up to you how you will do it. I hope this was not too complicated and I hope you did enjoy it. Once again, thank you so much for all your support you gave me in the past. Without you I wouldn't be here, so thank you very much. I hope this year will bring us more enjoyable craft, because craft is very important for our minds. It's good, relax, and it's perfect to make a gift for our loved ones and make us happy. So thank you so much for visiting me today. Thank you so much for spending your time with me. Don't forget to click on the link down below for downloading this free freebie. If you are interested in this cover, there will be a link as well. And have a good day. Take care about yourself, and I will see you soon. Bye.